let us start our discussion. Today I'll be discussing these topics. Those are subsystem design processes, in which we'll be discussing some general considerations and an illustration of design process. Right, so let us start with some general considerations. So here we have some parameters which we'll be improving by having the fabrication process. Right, so already we have discussed these parameters in the previous videos only. So let us start with some problems. See, here we'll be getting around three problems. So which are those means? So how to design the large complex systems in a reasonable time? So if any complex design is been given, so how to design that, and which architecture we need to choose for that, and how to test once it is fabricated on a silicon? So these are the some questions some we'll be getting. So in order to find the answers, so here for the first and third problems we can have one solution, that is the approach in the design in a top-down manner. So that is nothing but what is the meaning of top-down manner means? See, the larger complex designs can be divided into sub small designs, right? So in order to explain this, I'll consider one example, that is in order to design a full ladder. So how will you design 1-bit full ladder? So the consider that it's a one complex design, right? So that is the top level design. So the 1-bit full ladder design can be divided into two sub designs. So what are those? Two half ladders, right? So we know that we can design that 1-bit full ladder by using two half ladders, right? So again, how those half ladders can be designed? So those are designed with the help of one AND gate and when XOR gate, isn't it? So those are the lowest levels of cells, those AND gate and OR gate. So those two cells can be called as leaf cells, right? So this is the method in which we are following in top-down manner. So the same process or the same methodology can be implemented here, right? So once we design in a top-down manner, then a proper computer-aided tools to do this particular job, right? And generate and then verify each section of the design. So these works can be done by the computer aided tools only. And the next solution what we have is the 30% of the chip area can be reserved for the design testability circuits, right? So these design testability circuits can be built into the system from the outset and be prepared to devote a significant proportion, that is 30% of area, to test and verify the circuits on the silicon chip, right? So these are the some problems we have and solutions also we have. So see here, an illustration of design process. See, in representing a design, just now we have discussed we can represent a design in a top-down manner. So how that can be done means, see here we can have some different stages of the design processes, like conventional circuit symbols we can have, right? And logic symbols we can have. So the same design can be represented in stick diagrams, or any mixture of logic symbols and stick diagrams is also convenient. And then mask layouts, and or else in terms of some block diagrams and the floor plans. So these are the some stages of. So next we'll start with the general arrangement of a 4-bit processor. So here we have four blocks. Those are memory block, ALU block, control block and input output block. And here we have three buses: the control bus, the address bus and the data bus. So here mainly we are concentrating on the data path, that is how the data is moving into the registers and into ALU and then again back to the other blocks, that is memory block to control block and to IO block. So this is the basic structure of a processor. So see, when you look at this first block diagram, see here we have separate two buses for the input data and for output data, right? The data is coming from the one bus and the data is going out from the diagram or that is block from the another bus, right? So here the data path is unidirectional. So coming to the second diagram, so here the data path is bidirectional, that is nothing but the data is coming into the block and it is leaving the block from the same bus, isn't it? So here the data path is a bidirectional. Now here, see, these are the control signals, right, for both the blocks. When you consider the control signals and the data signals, they are represented like this. The data is moving bidirectionally by this horizontal path, right? And similarly for the control signal, it is flowing parallel with this data path, that is it is moving vertically, right? So the control signal is flowing vertically and the data signals are flowing horizontally. So this is the one possible interconnection strategy we have here. See, here it shows the subunits and basic interconnections for a data path. See, when you consider the data path is represented horizontally, right? So here this is a bidirectional data path and this is the unidirectional and this is also unidirectional. Now coming to this control signals, so all these signals vertically which are represented are the control signals: the direction control, select and control, operation control and shift control. So this is the representation of that data path and control signal, that is control path.